Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yeah. So in the previous class, yesterday we have seen what does a electric circuit mean and how does current is helping us to make the work done in the circuit and how does the current exist. Okay. And also we have seen the quality of a conductor. Okay, so I thought today briefly we will take the other two materials, what happens over there. So in conductor, my voice is clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in conductor, we have seen the number of valence electrons are less. So therefore, the number of covalent bonds to be broken to make the electrons free are very less. So less amount of energy is required to make the electrons free. Okay. But what happens with semiconductor and insulator is obviously here the number of covalent bonds are more. Okay. Here there are four covalent bonds. So these four covalent bonds are to be broken if the current has to be conducted in the semiconductors. Okay. So this number of bonds are more. So therefore, the amount of external energy required to make the current flow in semiconductor is slightly larger than that we require in the conductor. So only you have seen the diode. Diode will not conduct until the forward biased voltage is 0.7 volts if silicon and 0.3 volts if germanium. Up to 0.7 volts of the applied voltage, diode will operate as an insulator, okay, or as a bad conductor. But once we apply 0.7 volts to that diode, then automatically my conduction starts because the electrons have gained sufficient amount of energy so that they will get themselves free from the valence orbits and they start flowing. And if I want to continue that flow, if I want to make the flow continue, then I should be supplying continuous amount of energy. So this V is the continuous amount of energy that we have to supply. So the moment I take out this external voltage, my conduction stops. Okay. The same is with insulators. The insulators are having more number of electrons when compared to the semiconductors and conductors in their valence orbits. Okay. So I need to now break much more number of covalent bonds. So I need large amount of energy. It is not that insulators cannot conduct current. They do conduct current, but at very large voltages. The best example is conduction of current in air. Okay. We know lightning. Okay. So what is lightning? Lightning is nothing but conduction of current in air. The charge flow from the clouds or from the space to the ground. Okay. In the space, when the clouds collide, okay, when the clouds actually in the general sentence we say clouds collide, but actually what happens in the clouds is clouds are, if you see, if you go to Nandi Hills, you will feel the clouds at your hands, but when you want to touch it, you don't feel any mass in your hand. Then how does a massless quantity collide with each other? That makes sense, is it? Clouds is nothing but it is a form of a fog. When I, is it possible for me to collide two fogs which are very light in weight? Here, when we say clouds collide means, and the thunder sound whatever we get, it is not because of the collision of those clouds, it is because of the shock waves. Okay. The shock waves are created in the space. And these shock waves are created because of accumulation of large amount of charges. Okay, shock waves are created because we have seen lightning comes first, thunder comes later, because the the speed of light is much much higher than the speed of sound. Okay, speed of sound is 230 kilometer per hour. Okay, and speed of light is around 3 lakh meters per second or so, like that. Now what happens when the large amount of charges are accumulated in the space? The charge accumulation may be because of any phenomena. We are interested in the accumulation. Why they are accumulating at this point, let us not worry about that. So when there is large amount of charge accumulation happening in the space, the nature of charge accumulation is such that the charges always try to flow from higher potential point to lower potential point. Okay, that is the reason why current flows in any material. Why current flows? How current flows? We saw in this part, we saw how current flows. But why current flows? When electrons gain energy, why they have to move? Why they have to flow? Any reason?
Because of potential energy. Difference of potential energy.
Because of potential energy. Yes. Let the potential energy be like that. What is the problem? Why electrons have to move? Have you come across the word equilibrium state?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. See, everything in the nature wants to stay at equilibrium state. Everything in the nature. Okay? It wants to stay at its equilibrium state. So what is the equilibrium state of an electron? It has to be inside the atom, revolving around the nucleus, is it? That is the equilibrium state of an electron. Now, when I give external energy to this electron, it will gain some energy. Now, if it gains energy, it cannot be in equilibrium state. To become or to be at equilibrium state, it has to spend that energy. To spend that energy, electron will move. Is it? This is very fundamental chemistry or physics you might have studied in plus one or plus two classes. Everything is interrelated. Just a small deep thoughts are necessary. Why current flow? Because electrons gain energy, but electron wants to stay at an equilibrium state, so it will start spending energy. And if I want continuous current, I am applying continuous voltage. There is continuous application of external energy. There is continuous gaining of external energy by an electron, and there is continuous spending of external energy by electron by flowing. Okay. Now the moment I stop this voltage, the moment stops, current becomes zero. That is the reason why current flows. Okay. So in lightning, what happens? There are large amount of charges accumulated in the space, and when the charge accumulation is beyond certain limit, they try to flow from one point to other point. Okay, if at this space, this is one cloud, this is another cloud, okay, and this is my earth. Now there are charge accumulation, there are some charges I assume to be positive because I assume earth to be negative, and here we have more charge accumulation. Now, suppose this is cloud X and this is cloud Y. So cloud Y is having more amount of charge when compared to cloud X. So the nature of charge is what? It has to flow from higher potential point to lower potential point. So number of charges in Y are much higher than number of charges in X. Then if they are in the close vicinity, if X and Y are in the close vicinity, the charges try to flow from higher potential point to lower potential point. Okay, or lower potential point to higher potential point. These charges start getting attracted towards Y because X is more negative than Y. Here plus indicates higher potential point, minus indicates lower potential point. So X is more negative than Y. So lower potential point charges try to get attracted towards higher potential point. Okay, then what will happen? So these charges will either flow from X to Y or Y to X. Whatever may happen, let us not worry about the physics of polarity. We'll see the process. When these charges flow, these are shock waves. These are shock waves. Now, when these charges are flowing, this is what? Okay, thunder. Lightning we don't see. Sometimes lightning we see only when the lightning strikes to ground. If you see certain videos which are taken from the aircrafts, you can see the lightning between the clouds. Okay, if you go through certain videos, you can see lightning between the clouds. That lightning is not hitting the ground, but still there is lightning between the clouds. So many a times we hear thunders, but rarely we see the lightning hitting the ground, is it? Have you observed this phenomena, especially in monsoon, start of the monsoon? This happens generally in the month of April, May, June, especially May and June. Yes or no? In this core monsoon season, we don't get these thunders and lightning. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this phenomena we see at the start of the monsoon, not during the core monsoon season. Because during core monsoon season, already the clouds have been formed completely. We can say that all are at equipotential only. But whereas at the start of the monsoon, there are no clouds which are carrying the rain. And there is a formation of the cloud. So some clouds are formed here, some clouds are formed here. Because of variation in the potential between those two. There are shock waves traveling between two clouds, and those shock waves are nothing but my thunder. Okay, now observe the space between cloud X and cloud Y is air. What is air? Air is an insulator. Is it? Air is an insulator, but it is conducting. So insulators will also conduct, provided very large amount of energy supplied externally. Now what happens? Because of large accumulation of, I will take one more here. This is Earth. This is cloud. And there are large accumulation of charges here. Now, when large accumulation of charges start occurring near the clouds in the space at some distance above the ground, then the air surrounding this cloud start getting ionized. We know that atom is neutral at its equilibrium state, but when atom gets external energy, it start getting ionized. Now, if I take out an electron out of that atom, that becomes positive ion. If I add an electron to an atom, that becomes negative ion. Is it? So here what happens? Ionization of the air starts surrounding the cloud. Now when this ionization come and reach the ground, okay? When this ionization will come and reach the ground, in that path, lightning strikes to the ground. This is lightning strike. This is how lightning occurs. Okay, this is all electrostatic process. This complete is electrostatic process. Okay, so now what is this air? This is air, and it is conducting. So if there is large amount of external energy supplied to the insulator, insulator will also start conducting. Okay, but with the general external energy or with general voltage values, normal voltage values, we say insulators will not conduct. Okay, because we are choosing insulators in any system depending upon the voltage value. Okay, the insulator what I choose at 230 volts may not be useful at 11,000 volts. The quality of insulator must be much higher. Okay, so the insulator will also conduct, semiconductor will also conduct, okay, conductor will also conduct, but at various voltage levels. So at normal voltage levels which conduct, that we call it as good conductor. At large voltages which they conduct, very large voltages, that is those are insulators. Or at normal voltages which they do not conduct, those are insulators. Okay, so now we got to know what is current, how current flows, and why current flows. Why current flows is important. Okay, and one hint from my side, suggestion: if you want to understand any subject, any concept in any course, you try to answer two questions: how and why. If you try to get answers for these two questions for anything, the understanding level of that concept or that course will be very high. You need not to buy heart anytime. You simply will start remembering the things because you have understood how the things are happening, why the things are happening. And this applies even in our general life also. Okay, if I get to know all the events what are happening in my life, how they are happening and why they are happening, I will not be a miserable person. I will be a rational person, and at least I will be keeping calm because I know the reason why it is happening. Okay, so if you try to answer these two questions in any concept, as per my experience, what I have understood is understanding level of that concept will be very high, very good. Okay, try this. Okay. Yeah. So this is the fundamentals of the current, how current flows, why current flows, what are the different materials. Okay, now we will come to our this circuit. Okay, we'll look into certain definitions of the circuit which we generally use in the analysis. Okay, you can see some important definitions. Okay, some basic definitions. Basic definitions. Okay, so in that, first is electric circuit. Electric circuit already we have discussed in the previous class, that it is simply a closed path. Okay, it is a closed path for the flow of currents. Closed path for current flow. I will be using short forms, please don't mind, because writing is a bit different than writing on board or paper. Okay, so please bear with that. Closed path for current flow. Okay, it is a closed path for current flow that contain or consist circuit elements. or connection of circuit elements. Okay, so already we have seen, we have a circuit. I will draw a simple circuit here. So I will let us name the corners. Let this be A, B, C, D, E, and F. So this is a circuit. So it is a closed path for the flow of current. Current can flow through R1, R2 back to this source, or R1, R3 through voltage source through R2, or in any way. Okay, so this is a closed path for the flow of current. Okay, so this is a circuit which provides the closed path for the flow of current. Second is circuit element. Element or circuit element? Okay, so circuit element is the circuit component. Okay, it is a circuit component connected in, or circuit component connected in a particular manner. So these all are the components. Current source is a component. Resistance 1 is a component. Resistance 2 is component. R3 is a component. Voltage source is component. Okay. So for example, I can say, okay, voltage source, okay, current source, you can say resistance, inductance, capacitance, inductance, capacitance, you can say diode, whatever. Okay, anything that I connect in the circuit is a circuit element. Anything that I connect in a circuit is a circuit element. Okay, so connection of circuit elements forms the circuit. Connection of circuit elements forms the circuit. Okay, next is electrical network or network. Network is interconnection of circuit elements. Electric circuit is also interconnection of circuit elements. Then what is the difference between these two is, when we say network, network is considered to be the bigger form of circuits. If there are interconnection of various circuits, okay, say we can call basically interconnection of circuits or circuit elements. Interconnection of circuit or circuit element. To be given as an example, say for in our college, if you consider, in each room there are fans, there are tube lights, lamps connected, and there are some open pins where I can connect anything I want. So to that room it will form a circuit. For example, the connection of lamps, tube lights, the connection of fans, and some connections, those are openly given in a classroom, that will form a circuit. Now such I have circuit in every class. But if you consider in the lab, the connections are little bit different. For example, if we have if we consider the machines laboratory, in machines laboratory the circuit is different. In machines laboratory, the circuit consisting of connections of motors, connections of transformers, connections of generators, various other devices or appliances, or you can say machines. So lab is one circuit, classroom is another circuit. But if you consider the electrical connection of the entire college, each room is having its own circuit. But when I consider the entire circuit connection or the entire connection of the college, I say that forms a network. So that is interconnection of circuit. But generally in our general talk, the circuit and the network are interchangeably used. Okay, we don't take much difference to define what is electric circuit and what is electric network. We use interchangeably, but network is the bigger understanding of the, or bigger view of the circuit. Okay, so next is branch. Okay, branch is nothing but path. Okay, or you can say part of electric circuit. Part of circuit that carries current. Okay, so here if you consider in this circuit drawn, you can see various branches. So this AB is a branch, BC is a branch, BE is a branch, AF is a branch, FE is a branch, CD is a branch, DE is a branch, BE is also a branch. So these are all branches. So it is where the current flows, exactly where the current flows. So the part of the circuit that carries current, okay, part of the circuit that carries current is called a necessary. It is not necessary that it should carry some, or it should have some component. See, there is no component here between F and E, and if I connect these two points with a solid wire, that will also become a branch, but a short circuited branch. Okay, the potential of F and E will be same, but if I use two different wires, it will become a branch. Okay, so it is a part of circuit that carries current. But when it will carry current? Okay, current will exist in this branch only if there is potential difference between the ends of the branches or edges of the branch. Okay, the if the potential difference between the branches, branch ends, is zero, then the current will not be carried by the branch. So here, if a current has to be carried from point A to point B, point A should be at higher potential and point B should be at lower potential, the conventional current we are talking here. If the current has to be carried from branch C to B to C, then branch B should be at higher potential point, then branch C should be at lower potential point. So if there exists potential difference between the branches, then only current will exist in that branch. If both are at the same potential, current does not exist between those two branches. Now, for example, if you take F and E are at the same potential because they are directly connected. So we can say eventually that the current doesn't exist in this branch between F and E. Then how does the closed path is formed? If current doesn't exist between any two ends, that I take it as effectively open circuit. Then here I am saying this as a closed loop. Okay, I am saying this as a closed loop. A, B, E, F, A is a closed loop. But I say there is no current between F to E. How it is possible? Because F and E are at the same potential. Actually, all these connections are considered to be the ground connections. Okay, so current will start from the source and enter the ground. those things you don't much worry at this point, you just understand. So branch is that part of circuit which carries current, okay, and it will carry current only if there is a potential difference across it. If potential difference is zero, then both the ends are at the same potential, hence current will not be carried. Already we have seen in the previous discussion that if current has to be carried in any element, then there should be difference in potential. Okay, if the two points are at the same potential, suppose point A and point B are at the same potential, it means no point is at higher potential or no point is at lower potential. Therefore, flow of charges will not occur if the potential are of the same value. If there is a difference, then only the flow of charges will occur. Okay, so this is the branch. Next is node. Okay, so node is the point, or you can call it junction. Certain things you already know, okay, but still it is a repetition. Point or junction where more than two branches meet. Node is a point or junction where more than two branches meet. Okay, so if you observe the circuit, there are two nodes. Point B is a node, okay, point B and point E. These two are the nodes. A will not form a node because A doesn't have the three branches connected. Okay, so point or junction where more than two branches meet, or we can say where current gets divided. Where current gets divided. Okay, so you observe at point A, current is not getting divided. Whatever the current I is there, the same current is flowing in R1. At point B, current is getting divided. At point C, current is again not getting divided. At D, it is not getting divided. At E, it is getting divided or getting added up. At F, it is not getting divided. So only point B and point E are the nodes in the circuit, whereas the other points are, you can consider it as a corner of the circuit. You can take it as corners. Okay, only in the drawing we will get to know this is a corner. If you physically connect this current source to R1, you will not find any corner. To understand in the circuit drawing, these are formed as corners. But actually, if you do the physical connection, you can observe. Now, suppose I have this R1, I have this R2, and I have this R3, and I have the current source, and I have the voltage source. How do I do the connections? I will take one wire and connect directly. I will take another wire. I will take another wire and connect. I will take one more wire. Like this, I will do the connections. You can't find corners. The corners are found only in the on paper when we are analyzing it. Okay. So this is the node, okay, where more than two branches meet, and especially where the current gets divided. Okay. Then next is mesh. Before mesh, we have to see one more thing. Loop. Okay. Loop. Now, loop is very generally, we can call loop as closed path. Okay. Closed path for flow of current. Closed path for the flow of current. Now, what is loop? loop, if you want to observe in the circuit, you have to start from a node. Now, any path for the flow of current start at a particular node and ends at the same node, that is called the loop, because that will form one complete loop. Now, here you can observe. Here you can observe, let us take at point A, okay, at point A let us take, I assume the current will start at point A, it will go to C, it will come back through D and it will finish it here. So this is a loop. There can be another loop, it will start at A, okay, it will come and end here only. So this is also a loop. There can be another loop from B, C, D, E, B. So loop is that closed path for the flow of current. Loop is that closed path for the flow of current, which start at a particular node and ends at the same node. This is one loop. I can take this as one loop. I will start at B, I will end at B, I will start at C, I will end at C. Those all are loops. Okay, simply it is a closed path. When I want to consider a loop, then I always take one node into my consideration, and from that node I will take the path for the current and come back to the same node, and that I will call it as loop. And which are the loops I want to consider, it depends upon my requirement. Okay. So that is a loop. Then one more term we come across is mesh. In basic electrical, when you were studying DC circuits, you might have interchangeably used loop and mesh. But there is a small difference between loop and mesh. Mesh is also a closed path for the flow of current. Closed path for flow of current, but one condition is there, such that there is no other closed path such that there is no other closed path or loop within it. Okay, so mesh is also a closed path. Mesh is also a closed path such that there is no other closed path within it. Now, if I want to say, for example, I will draw the same circuit here. So this is I, this is V. I will not write R1, R2 and all. Let me only name the points. Okay. Now observe, we called loop from point A, B, C, D, E, F, A. We called loop from A, B, E, F, A. Now observe, mesh is a special case of a loop where there is no loop within it. Now if you want to know what mesh is, you see here, if I consider the loop, this bigger loop, A, B, C, D, E, F, A, then there is one loop within it, which is A, B, E, F, A. And if I consider this loop A, B, E, F, A, there is no other closed path within this loop. So this will form mesh. Okay, mesh is what? Mesh is that closed path of the circuit where there is no other closed path existing within it. If I consider a closed path from A, B, C, D, E, F, A, there is one closed path existing within it. A, B, E, F, A, another closed path existing within it. B, C, D, E, B. So there are two closed paths existing within a bigger closed path A, B, C, D, E, F, A. I cannot call the bigger closed path as mesh. Now this is a loop. Whereas A, B, C, D, E, F, A is a mesh. Likewise, I have one more mesh. This is also a mesh. Okay. So loop can be here. It can be anything. It can be A, B, C, D, E, F, A, or A, B, E, F, A, or B, C, D, E, B. Okay. But whereas mesh can be only A, B, E, F, A, and B, C, D, E, B. Because within this A, B, E, F, A, and B, C, D, E, B, there is no other closed path existing. Okay. So every mesh is a loop, but not every loop is a mesh. Every mesh is a loop, because loop is what? Basically, loop is a closed path. Basically, loop is a closed path. So every mesh is a loop, but not every loop is a mesh, because mesh will not contain any closed path within itself. Any closed path within itself. So this is a simple difference between loop and mesh, but most of the times, generally, we interchangeably call these two. We call mesh analysis or loop analysis like that only. But generally, mesh is a very primitive closed path of the circuit, and loop can be any closed path of the circuit. Okay, so I will stop here my part of discussion. If there are don't leave the class yet, class is not over. Okay. If there are any what I can say, things you want to discuss, you want to you want elaborate understanding, you can discuss. Okay. And I told in the previous class that there will be a quiz after every class. Okay. Right now there will not be quiz. Now there is no quiz, but I will be sharing some questions by the end of the day. Okay, you have to answer. Questions will be, I will not give questions more than 5 per class. If the quiz has to, because this conduction of quiz is to make you people more attentive towards the lecture. That is the intention. Okay, it is not to burden you people. Okay, so please take it in a positive sense.